good day. It's October 29th, 2022, and that leaves us only 9 days before the midterm election. Many across the country had already voted early. I'm Esmeralda Padilla-Gold, and welcome to The Pulse.
And I'm Sam Buban. We begin with the news that nominates this week's headlines. Former President Donald Trump's Chief of Staff Mark Meadows, who has been subpoenaed by a special grand jury in Fulton County, Georgia, was ordered by a judge to comply and appear at the said special grand jury. According to a report by the Washington Post and the New York Times, Mark Meadows, who reportedly had been trying to avoid appearing at the special grand jury that was convened by Fulton County District Attorney Fannie Willis. District Attorney Fannie Willis, who is investigating the extent of Trump allies' multi-state efforts to influence the 2020 election in Georgia and elsewhere, had asked a South Carolina judge, because the former congressman is from South Carolina, filed a petition before South Carolina District Judge Edward Miller to rule on making Mark Meadows to appear in the Georgia investigation. Judge Edward Miller made the ruling on Wednesday, October 26, that Mark Meadows must testify.
The Brazilian runoff election between President Jair Bolsonaro and challenger Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, a former president and more popular to ordinary Brazilians, is heating up days before the October 30th, 2022 election. In this runoff election, according to the survey conducted by Quaes Polling, Lula da Silva is at 52.1% and Bolsonaro is at 47.9% among likely voters. For many who remembers, Bolsonaro, who was also elected in 2018, was behaving like Donald Trump in dealing with his critics and opponents in the Brazilian Congress, and was described by many as anti-democratic and misogynist, having verbally assaulted a Brazilian congresswoman in 2003. Bolsonaro adopted the abrasive, divisive style of Donald Trump in his presidency.
In a visibly growing civil war within the Republican Party between the establishment Republicans and Trumpian brand of Republicans, the Alaska GOP party officials rebuked Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell for supporting U.S. Senator Lisa Murkowski. The Alaska Senate Republican officials wanted the incumbent gone for good for supporting the impeachment of Donald Trump. Murkowski had prevailed as the top vote getter in the open primary in Alaska and is headed to a runoff election with main opponent Kelly Shondell Chewbacca, a Trump-endorsed Trump Republican.
We have more for you after a commercial break, so please stay with us.
Pure Medical Equipment provides top-notch quality medical supply equipment. Whether to rent or buy, Pure Medical Equipment and Supplies has it all.
Pure Medical Equipment is committed to serve and give back to Southern Nevada.
We deliver medical supplies and rentals to your door.
Welcome back to The Pulse. Uncle Sam, what's happening in the campaign trail?
First, we are going to sample what voters are saying or doing about this midterm election.
Hi, this is Sam again with The Pulse. We were invited here at the PICE, Philippine Institute of Civil Engineers Gala event for 2022. And here with me is the president of the USA chapter. And we're going to ask him, first I'm going to thank him for inviting us. And then, Mr. President, you did a wonderful job with your fellow officers organizing this event, and I was excited that you had a high profile or high ranking state official come to your event. So are you aware of the 2022 election?
Yes.
Okay. Well, from what state are you?
Nevada.
Yeah. So you're from Nevada.
Yes.
And are you a registered voter?
I'm a registered voter.
Yeah, that's wonderful. So again, you know, you did a wonderful job with this. I know it takes a lot of hard work, but I see that, you know, your event was successful.
Thank you so much.
And last word from you.
Yes, thank you so much for the event. We have so many distinguished speakers that came, shared their time to spend the fifth anniversary celebration of the Philippine Institute of Civil Engineers.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you again, Mr. President.
Thank you.
And look at, this is Malu Fabian.
Hello.
Malu, where are you from?
Nevada.
You're also
I'm local.
Las
Vegas, right. Nevada, yes.
And Malu, you know, there is a midterm election coming up. Are you a registered voter?
Yes, I am.
All right. And I know that many people are talking that this is one of the most important midterm election in 20 years. Are you gonna vote?
Of course. I have to exercise my right.
Good. That's a good answer, because I know that we're trying to educate many Filipinos to get involved in and get engaged in politics, or at least exercise their right to vote. And over here, this is Ernie Buo, is the vice president of the USA chapter, and together with the president and Malu, they did a lot of hard work to make this event happen. Engineer Buo, I was excited that you had even the state attorney general came to your event. And are you gonna vote in this midterm election?
Yes, I'm definitely voting, and thank you so much, Sam, for helping me and helping the organization invite our great Nevada State Attorney General Aaron Ford and State Senator Melanie Schiavo. The speeches were so nice, and we really enjoyed it. Thank you, and we really appreciate you taking the time out to invite them and to make them our guests, and it made our night very special. And yes, I'm going to be voting, and I'm very, very passionate about the constitutional right of people to vote, and I'm one of them, and I will be voting in November.
Well said. And again, Engineer Ernie Buo, Vice President of the USA chapter of the Philippine Institute of Civil Engineers. And I see that you actually had a very good, successful event.
Thank you, and it wouldn't have been successful had you not been to great friends and great supporters like you. And God bless everyone, and congratulations in advance to Attorney General Aaron B. Ford and State Senator Melanie Schiavo. I will be voting for both of you. Thank you again for coming.
Well said. Thank you, folks. While we were continue to follow people on the campaign trail, I bumped into Margie Gonzalez. She is one of the Filipino film community leaders in Clark County, Nevada. And she is also a former AAPI Clark County Commissioner for AAPI. And we're going to ask her a couple of questions. Marge,
Why is it important that all Filipino Americans who can vote should vote in this election?
That is really very important because mm-hmm. the only way we could have a large voice, a loud voice, mm-hmm. you know, is if we all vote. You know, anything that you want some change, mm-hmm. and let's say Filipinos see that there's something that needs to be changed, right. but how will they listen if they see, oh, you know what, the Filipino vote is just too small to even, so mm-hmm. they won't even listen, mm-hmm. You know, but if they see, oh, wow, that's a big chunk of votes that we will, you know, we will lose if we don't listen to them,
that's right.
then yeah. things get done, mm-hmm. you know, so anything, any changes or things that we need to get done, like healthcare, education, mm-hmm. you know, something that's good for the state, the county, and our community, it will be done. If we have a loud voice, they will listen.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Are you gonna vote? Are you going to vote early? Because Nevada is one of those states that has early voting.
Yes, definitely. Not only will I be voting early. Mm-hmm. I'm actually staging a big Get Out the Vote event mm-hmm. at the Boulevard Mall, which is one of the long-term polling place. So we will do a walk to the polls event on that day.
All right.
So we are encouraging fellow Filipinos, regardless of who you are voting, please go out and vote.
Yes. And how about those who are eligible to vote, but they hadn't voted yet, what can they do?
You know, for this election, they can even register the same day, like before they walk to the polls. They can register and they can vote on that moment, that, you know, that day, that, you know, it can be done. So there's no excuse. So right. as long as they go out, they go there to the polling place, register, then vote.
All right. Margie Gonzalez, one of our Filipino film leaders in Clark County, Nevada. Thank you for agreeing to talk to us.
Thank you too.
The Filipino community are getting more and more involved during this election cycle. Here are some scenes at a big gathering of candidates organized by Gloria Kawili. From the Filipino American community, his name is Carlos Vasquez, and we are going to ask him some questions. Carlos, I'm sorry to interrupt your... Are you going to vote on this election day?
Yes, sir. Every year, every election, I always vote. I'm a Republican. As a Republican.
Okay. And why is it important for you that Republicans take some of the seats in our state legislature?
Well, you know, I've just been a Republican since the beginning.
Okay.
And this is what I believe, so. And so far, you know, it's all good.
All right. Are you aware that only the Democratic Party is actually protecting our immigration program worldwide, with more Filipinos coming in into these countries in the what Trump described as a chain migration, which he's trying to stop?
No, I'm not aware of that.
Okay. All right. Thank you again, Carlos. Thanks for agreeing to talk to us.
Candidates are also ramping up the efforts to let the voters know the issues the Nevadans are concerned about and acknowledging the different sectors, the importance of unity with candidates. Even on the rising apartment rentals in Nevada, here's what State Senator Melanie Scheibel said.
Of eviction cases in Nevada that come from Clark County and through the Las Vegas Justice Court. We're going to be working on reaching people before they're facing an eviction. finding ways to contact people when they are a month behind in rent or when they anticipate getting behind in rent and not waiting until they're 6 months behind in rent, can never catch up, have already lost their job and are working on trying to pay off healthcare bills at the same time. We're going to reach them earlier. We're going to provide them with services. We're going to figure out exactly how much they need to bridge the gap. We're going to help them bridge those gaps, and we're going to reduce the number of evictions here in Clark County and in the rest of the state of Nevada. I mentioned earlier job creation, but really diversification of our economy as well. We're built on tourism here, and that is a wonderful, wonderful thing. But I think it's also very important that we diversify our economic base so that when we run into disasters in the future, we're able to bring in a larger tax base in order to ensure we're paying for education, for health care, and for housing affordability, and to be able to take care of our basic necessities. Because having a roof over our heads and having safe, affordable housing, as was said earlier, is a right for everyone in this state. So thank you so much.
According to an organization tracking the voting nationwide, the Democrats outnumber the Republicans in mail-in ballot submission and in-person turnout in the early voting in states that allows it, in Nevada and national total. According to the network NBC, the number of votes already cast in this midterm election has exceeded the numbers of votes cast than in the previous elections. But just a word of caution for the Democrats, the Republican voters tend to vote in person during Election Day. That is, the recent candidates continue to make their rounds and messaging all the way to the day of the election.
Here is Congressman Stephen Horsford speaking before a big crowd of Filipino Americans.
Just how important our voice is in this process. And when I look in this room, it's why I love Nevada. It's why I love Las Vegas. Because look at us. Look at how diverse and strong we are as a people, as a community. And the Filipino American community here in Southern Nevada is strong, it's growing, and I want to thank the leaders of this community who have helped teach me about the priorities that we need to deliver on your behalf. Definitely the Filipino Nurses Association who hold it down, and to SEIU 1107 and all of the to our Filipino educators throughout our school district. To Mark and Gloria and Rosetta and Luisa, and everyone who has done your part over the years to help build.
And Governor Steve Sisolak, this is what he said in his speech for votes among our fellow Filipino voters.
We accomplished a lot of good stuff, but what Dina said is absolutely true. All the good that we did, they want to undo. They want to roll it all back, and then some. They don't believe in unions. They don't believe in minority rights. They don't believe in a woman's right to choose. That's how far they've gone. And if you think the Supreme Court is going to stop there, you're sadly mistaken. They're coming after somebody next, whoever that's going to be. We can't let that happen. We cannot let it take a step backwards. So they're going to be real close. They're going to be margin of error races. That means we need to turn out every single person. We need to turn out every single person that can vote to vote. And whether you vote, as Dina says, by mail, or you vote in person, or you vote day of, you can register the day of the election and vote, right until the polls close. So when you run into somebody that says, well, I can't vote, I'm not registered, you tell me you can go register right now, and you can go vote. Now, we got great candidates from our Attorney General who's here, and I don't know if Zach is here, or Lisa's here, and all our legislative and our future legislators, and we're proud of you. We are so proud of you, I can't tell you. I'm looking forward to working with you, Carson City. But we can't do it without you.
There is a United Nations summit in November this year in Egypt relating to climate change. Congresswoman Dina Titus is working to address the issue on climate change. Climate change and global warming has been in the priority for the Democrats in Congress. Here's Dina Titus working with young Filipina youth leader Angeline Tabalba of the AAPI Young Leadership.
Well, thank you very much for joining us this morning. I'm Dina Titus. I represent this district in Congress, and I'm so delighted to be here with our councilwoman, Olivia Diaz, and our assemblyman, Edgar Flores, who do so much to represent this district and have been great partners in using the federal funding to help us at the state level and at the local level, and it's an honor to work with them. Also, Angeline is here representing some of the young people and some of the organizations that are so interested and so involved in climate change. You know, if you do polling, you find that the issue young people care the most about is climate change, and that rightly so, because it is their future, it is their planet. But it's interesting to look at all the figures, how climate change affects their education, where they live, their health, their future because of the jobs that become available, and just their quality of life. It will make it affordable for Nevada families to make their homes more energy efficient because it provides rebates if families want to buy certain kind of utilities and appliances that are more efficient. These rebates can be from 50 to 100% of the cost of these new electric appliances. That would include clothes dryers and water heaters and stoves, those things you use every day.
So when I see our Congresswoman and our entire federal delegation devoted to ensuring that it's not only a better country, but a better planet, and then we are cohesively and collectively, all of us coming together to leave something better after we leave this planet. So that's why having her leadership is so important. But next, I'd like to introduce a young woman who's been incredibly involved in our community. Angeline is a communications director with the Nevada Conservation League, and I think she's going to give a very important perspective. So if we could please have her join us.
Thank you so much, Assemblyman, and thank you for your leadership and your work that you provide to our community. Good morning. I want to say it's official. We passed the largest, most significant climate bill in history. The Inflation Reduction Act of 2022 is going to put our nation on the path to cut pollution in half by 2030, create millions of good-paying, clean energy jobs. It's going to invest in environmental justice, reduce energy bills for working families across the country. My name is Angeline, and on behalf of the Nevada Conservation League, we are beyond excited about the critical climate and clean energy investments this law offers that Congresswoman Titus just spoke about. Now, those rebates and tax credits for electrifying their homes, appliances, and vehicles, the Inflation Reduction Act is going to help families cut energy costs while we help cut climate warming pollution as well. Now, building on top of these investments, Nevadans are going to be able to look forward to good paying union jobs that are going to result from expanding our clean energy economy. And the $369 billion climate and clean energy investments from this law is going to add national leadership and funding that's going to bolster investments Nevada has already made in our state's clean energy economy. Now, this is a big deal, especially for young people who are going to inherit this earth after our leaders leave it behind. Now, climate change is the greatest threat facing the world's children and young people. Now, children born today are going to face climate change risks, including extreme heat, extreme weather events, poor air quality, and disease. And these extreme and high temperatures can put children at risk of illness and death. Air pollution from burning fossil fuels are going to contribute to chronic respiratory diseases, and those risks heighten for communities of color. Now, about 8.5% of all Hispanic children and 23.5% of all Puerto Rican children have asthma, which is 3 times higher than the average rate for non-Hispanic whites. Black children under 17 are up to 40% more likely to be diagnosed with asthma under 2 degrees of global warming. Now, we know the risks to our communities when we don't act on climate, and that's why it's inherent that our elected officials do everything in their power to fight for stronger climate action. The Inflation Reduction Act and the Bipartisan Infrastructure Law are historic investments in the future of our climate, and it shows us what is possible when we elect climate champions into elected office. But if we want to continue and build on this progress, we have to double down on our efforts and support candidates who have a strong track record in advancing environmental protection and a healthy climate. That's why today I'm proud to stand alongside Congresswoman Dina Titus, Councilwoman Olivia Diaz and Assemblyman Flores, who have been champions of the environment and our kids. It really has never been a more important time to elect strong environmental champions, especially in Nevada, where communities know all too well the devastating effects of the climate crisis. Now, from local county commission races to Carson City and even to Washington, D.C., the future of our climate and our environment relies on who we elect to office. Again, I want to thank Congresswoman Titus, Councilwoman Diaz, and Assemblyman Flores for your leadership in protecting our environment and investing in a clean energy economy.
It's good to see that the future of this planet, the planet we will leave behind for our children, is high on the agenda of the Democrats in Congress.
It really is. It is an issue the power brokers in the Republican Party does not want to talk about. That is why the members of the right side of the chambers don't speak about it. It has something to do with the lobby of the powerful oil and energy cartel, the giant oil companies. We are almost at the end of our show, so reminder again to all, vote by mail, go vote in person in the midterm election. You can still register and vote even on election day. And have a safe week, exercise your right to vote, and see you on the next episode.
Thank you for watching. I'm Esmeralda Padilla-Gold.
And I'm Sam Buban.
Mabuhay.
The views and opinions expressed in the media or comments on this program are those of the speakers or authors and do not necessarily reflect or represent the views and opinions held by PhilanTV Network. Due to the social nature of PhilanTV Network, videos may contain content copyrighted by another entity or person. PhilanTV Network claims no copyright to said content.